When you've got nothing to lose. You're invisible now. No secrets to conceal. Let's go for a walk. What do I know? What do I know? That which doesn't kill just makes things grow. Hi Gawkers, it's May the 10th, 2011. I thought I'd do a walking vlog today because A, I need the flipping exercise. Yes, I do. And B, I did the last video you saw from me was immediately after the tornadoes hit. And I just kind of wanted you to see how our neighborhood has come together after all of this. And there's a car. And there's no sidewalks to really walk on right now. We're in the middle of the street because, well, let me show you. All of this, as you can see, up and down the street, we have tons of debris around here. You can still hear a chainsaw going. We have tons of debris still lining the streets. We are waiting for, we thought the county was doing it, but apparently the Army Corps of Engineers is actually coming around picking all this up. And they are taking it off to be burned. So they're being real strict about this has to be brush only, limbs only and stuff. Wow, it's been a week and several days, almost 2 weeks since the storm. You can see that house behind me with tarps all over it. Just about every other house in the neighborhood has a tarp on it right now. That one's got a tarp on it. This one right here was badly hit. Two trees hit it. And I'm back off the sidewalk again because of this. Well, that's my neighborhood. So what's going on today? Dear President Barack Obama, you went to college. You went to a damn good college. You have a legal education. Please use correct grammar. Today you said in your speech about immigration policy, the system is broke. Well, that's great if you're talking about the budget. I don't think you were though, because the context was not about money. I think what you meant to say is the system is broken. But when you say the system is broke, that means it has no money. Dear President Barack Obama, bagging Osama bin Laden does not get you out of using correct grammar. As you can see, I'm really concerned about my health. Out smoking and walking at the same time. Anyway, on NPR today, there was a law professor at University of Tennessee who, as a hobby, has tried to research the most frequently cited song lyricist in legal precedence. And it turns out Bob Dylan is number one. By far and away, outpacing the Beatles and the Rolling Stones. Who knew? So, the lyrics today that introduced this video were Like a Rolling Stone by Bob Dylan. It's just something I was thinking of, because that's the last thing I heard before I got home. To a lovely home-cooked meal. My wife insisted I tell you that. She insisted that this video today is brought to you by the Barefoot Scatological Research Institute and Mrs. the Barefoot, who put a bunch of stuff in a bunch of crock pots, so I had a hot meal when I walked in the door. Probably the first time that's ever happened in the house I've lived in 8 years. One of the many t-shirts you can get at theBarefoot, Barefoot Scatological Research Institute. I just passed some neighbors coming out of their houses saying, the power's out. I hope it's only on their street, but I live in the back of the neighborhood, so on my street too. Probably still repairing lines up the way, and that means they are turning power on and off kind of frequently. They say our power system is still a little frail and fragile because we are not actually back up to 100% of the feeds we're supposed to get from the TVA. So And yes, my wife is standing out in the yard, so I assume our power is out. But at least I got a hot meal before it all ended. Okay, let's go figure this out. Keep chasing the odd little happy, he said as the bug ran into his neck.
Balls to you!
I got the sun behind me now. So, on NPR, I heard a story where this law professor, as a hobby, has been cataloging how often... Crap. Chainsaw!
Balls to you!
Oh, sure, my daughter's running away. Power's out, run away. She's going to work.
Balls to you!
Yes, I know, we have no power.
Balls to you!
I heard it one street over. Power's out, right?
Yep.
It just went pop!
Tell them all about your beautiful dinner, though, that you cooked before the power went
yes,
out.
Yes, I've been cooking in the crock pot all day long.
Oh, slaving over that crock pot.
I thought I was Rachel Ray.